Texas 4-H, let me be the first to congratulate you and welcome you to tonight's celebration event. Who would have thought that in August, when we were enrolling in our 4-H programming, that this is how we would be celebrating your accomplishments? But here we are, making the most of it. I want to go on record to let you know that I appreciate your spirit. You are living the 4-H motto, to make the best better. I've been reading and studying a lot lately, because we've had time to do that, that growth happens most, or most growth happens, through struggle, adversities, and trials. Well, we probably won't recognize ourselves in August because the adversity is here. I trust that you found ways to make yourself better, to do more for yourself. Find a new hobby. Maybe you're reading more. Maybe you're spending more time with that project that you've grown to love. Maybe you've even found ways to contribute to your community. But I'm proud of you, and I want to congratulate you for that. One day, we will be on the other side of this crisis, and we will be able to celebrate in our normal way. Think back on the things that you have done, you have learned, you have accomplished, even in this crisis. One day we will be able to merge the two programs together, the virtual experience along with our more normal, traditional experience. And it's going to be a really good program. Nevertheless, tonight we're celebrating you. We're celebrating Texas 4-H. Grab a bowl of popcorn and enjoy the show.
Howdy, my name is Mark Holman, and I'm from Tongan County, District 7. Now, if you will please join me in the salute to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hi, I'm Parker Galvan from Hidalgo County and South District 12. Please join me in reciting the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
My name is Sean Earthman, and I'm from Knox County in District 3. Please join me in reciting the 4-H motto and pledge. In support of the 4-H Club motto, to make the best better, I pledge my head to clearer thinking, my heart to greater loyalty, my hands to larger service, and my health to better living. For my club, my community, my country, and my world.
I got a feeling.
Laramie Crockett at Large Delegate.
Lainey Bowman at Large Delegate.
Elisa Rodriguez at Large Delegate.
Parker Galvan, Hidalgo County, South District 12.
Avery
Kibeka, Matagorda County, District 11.
Zane Wanyura, Colorado County, District 11.
Shannon Anderson, Guadalupe County, District 10.
Colby Warwick, Travis County, District 10.
Bailey Lyon, Lee County, District 9.
Kason Foreman, Walker County, District 9.
Zach Holscher, McLennan County, District 8.
Zane Copeland, Sterling County, District 7.
Peyton Royal, Glasscock County, District 6.
Reed Seidenberger, Glasscock County, District 6.
Kara Pinkerton, Smith County, District 5.
Fenton Nobles, Smith County, District 5.
Laura Newman, Fannin County, District 4.
Eric Dietrich, Denton County, District 4.
Sean Earthman, Knox County, District 3.
Young County, District 3. Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it.
Molly Johnson, Castro County, District 2.
Lydia Miller, Appleton County, District 1.
Alex Smith, Hemphill County, District 1.
Mark Holtman, Tom Green County, District 7, Health and Safety Officer.
Seth Kendrick, At-Large Delegate, Public Relations Officer.
Gentry Jackson, At-Large Delegate, Secretary.
Ty Wilson, At-Large Delegate, Second Vice President.
Brayden DeBoard, Ellis County, District 8, First Vice President.
Grady McAllister, Castro County, District 2, President. Texas 4-H, we can't describe how much of a blessing it has been to serve y'all as y'all stand this year, and how much fun we've had and the experiences that we've made.
We love you,
Texas 4-H.
Picture this. You're sitting in the field. A storm is on the way, and it's planting season. Your tractor has run out of fuel, your planter has run out of seed, and there's a wheel bearing loose on the planter. In your pickup, you have a compressor and a bearing kit. Now you can either wait for someone else to come along with more fuel and seed to help you fix that bearing, or you can do it yourself, instead of depending on someone else to make something happen for you. Howdy, Texas 4-H. My name is Grady McAllister, and I am the 2019-2020 Texas 4-H Council President. If you're not a farmer, then this scenario probably makes zero sense to you. So let me elaborate. During planting season, there's often small windows of time where farmers can get their seeds in the ground. Now this often means either waiting for a rain or trying to beat a storm. As for the wheel bearings, they are very crucial, but often overlooked parts of a wheel. They keep the wheels turning. Texas 4-H, this year, we've had a storm thrown at us. We got most of our harvest in. We got some of our stock shows and contests and social gatherings, but our harvest was cut short. But through this all, y'all have proven what y'all really are as 4-H members, what we are as 4-H members. Resilient. We stand to make things stronger, and we strive to make the best better. But we often overlook the effects that we have on others as we're trying to make things happen for ourselves. Without realizing it, Texas 4-H, you are the wheel bearings for us council. You keep us going. We were devastated when we learned that Texas 4-H Roundup was canceled. The one chance to serve, the one chance to be able to work there, and we can't do it. But afterwards, we realized something that really helped us to keep going and to move forward. It's not about us. It's about y'all. The experiences and all of the social gatherings and the leadership development traits that we brag about as an organization, that we strive for and that we exemplify in our members, that is what it's about. We have that opportunity with the Virtual Lead Academy. Texas 4-H, the initiatives that y'all have taken in social distancing and in the virtual things that y'all have put on have inspired us to put this together for y'all. We cannot be prouder of y'all as members, the things that y'all have put together, and how hard y'all have worked to keep 4-H thriving during this time. Just as I said earlier, y'all are the bearings for us council. Y'all kept us rolling, and in that, we have tried to put this together for y'all. Yes, our harvest was cut short, but through this virtual meeting, we are planting new seeds, seeds of hope, seeds of inspiration, in the hope that one day we will be back to normal. We can have those dances, we can have those concerts that we've always bragged about as 4-H. We can once again come back together and see each other face to face. And just as strong as the West Texas wind is, and as sure as it will always blow, Texas 4-H, we will always be there for y'all. No, we didn't get the year that we'd hoped for. We got even better opportunities. We have technology, we have all of these wonderful things that we can now take advantage of that we didn't know was here. I had no clue what a Zoom meeting was. And now through all of this, through my Zoom meetings with council, with my district council, with everyone across the state, even through other states on the national level, I've been able to take part of opportunities that I didn't even know existed. There's always a silver lining. We're getting to see the direct results of the plants that of the seeds that we planted earlier in the year. We're getting to see that not through the planned harvest, but through an impromptu harvest. Texas 4-H, remember this and keep this in your minds. The members, which is y'all, are the bearings that keep this organization turning. Thank you for the best year of our lives, Texas 4-H. And please, tune in to Virtual Lead Academy, learn something, and go forward to plant more seeds of inspiration. Thank you.
Howdy, everyone, and welcome to Texas 4-H Celebration tonight. I'm happy to be able to join you and welcome you to this event that is unique, as many things are at this point in time, but I'm thankful that while we can't join together here on the campus of Texas A&M University, that we're able to have a chance to go ahead and celebrate the outstanding work that got you folks through to this point where you are tonight. My name is Jeff Hyde, and I serve as Director of Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Service. And I want to start by congratulating you seniors in the audience. And I know that many of you have done a lot of hard work to get to where you are tonight. And you're going to receive, many of you, scholarship funds as a result of the hard work that you've done and in recognition of what you've learned and contributed to the 4-H program. And you're to be congratulated for that. So, outstanding work. To those of you members who may not be seniors, but are still being recognized. And again, kudos for the hard work that you've put in. And I hope that all of you look back on your time in 4-H and echo what I hear from so many 4-H alumni, that their experience taught them important life lessons, things like managing time, public speaking, these sorts of things that are really important life lessons. And again, so many people I talked to who went through 4-H echo these sentiments, and hopefully that's you as well. Congratulations to Texas 4-H State Council on a successful year. It's been a year unlike any other, and you've come through it with a successful year with flying colors, and you're to be commended for the work that you've done this year. I want to say thank you to the 4-H families and our AgriLife Extension personnel, including the thousands of volunteers that support 4-H each year. It's been a challenging year, and yet I know that the youth of Texas have been well served, even in this time, as we've figured out ways to move things into online and take other approaches to programming. And so I think we're all to be commended for the work that you've done to continue to serve the youth of Texas. So thank you so much on behalf of all in AgriLife Extension. And again, I just want to say thank you to everyone. Congratulations and welcome to this amazing event. I hope you have a great evening as we celebrate excellence in the 4-H program. Thanks.
Howdy, I'm David White, Executive Director of the Texas 4-H Foundation. We are here tonight to honor our seniors who will be receiving a 4-H Foundation scholarship. Our Texas 4-H Youth Development Scholarship Program is the largest scholarship program in the country. And tonight we are excited to award over 200 scholarships to our outstanding 4-H members. In 1959, we awarded our first $1,000 scholarship, and tonight we are honored to award over $2.3 million in scholarships to our 4-H members. Before we begin, let me congratulate our 50,000 4-H members. You are part of the largest 4-H community in the country, and we appreciate everything that you do. We encourage you to share your experiences you've had with 4-H with your friends and encourage them to join 4-H as well. We especially are proud of our seniors. As the leaders of tomorrow, you will guide your communities and our 4-H family through this pandemic, and we will be stronger than ever. Your actions will show all of us that being a Texas 4-H member instills in you the fundamentals of being a successful leader. We wish you the best as you continue your life's journey. Now, let's announce our 2020 Texas 4-H scholarship recipients. First, we will announce the Richard Walworth Educational Foundation recipients. Each of these individuals will receive $10,000. Here is Richard and Patsy Walworth to share a few words.
Richard and Patsy Walworth with the Richard Walworth Educational Foundation, and we want to welcome you to our scholarship family. Although things have not been as we would have planned them, please don't give up on your goals. Remember that you are in Texas and the USA. Each one of you have the right to succeed. All you have to do is demand it. Don't accept the crumbs that people scrape off the table. Demand success in our free enterprise system. Remember, it would be better to attempt something great and fail than to do nothing and succeed. We look forward to hearing from you soon.
The following individuals will be receiving the 35 Richard Walworth Foundation scholarships in the amount of $10,000. Christopher Albus, Hockley County, District 2. Jacqueline Banda, Hale County, District 2. Keegan Brumfield, Calhoun County, District 11. Jamie Byram, Taylor County, District 7. Courtney Craig, Ellis County, District 8. Clint Dimmitt, Wise County, District 3. Taylor Everett, Lubbock County, District 2. Bryce Favor, Live Oak County, District 12. Veronica Galvan, Cameron County, District 12. Noah Garcia, Kaufman County, District 4. Mallory Grimes, Matagorda County, District 11. Bailey Halbert, Brazos County, District 9. Foster Hall, Cherokee County, District 5. McKenna Hall, Kerr County, District 10. Katerina Hernandez, Sutton County, District 10. Brock Kieschnick, Wilbarger County, District 3. Caitlin Klawinski, Walker County, District 9. Rebecca Kostron, Milam County, District 8. Clayton Matney, Wilson County, District 10. Cade McAdams, Baylor County, District 3. Emmy Minette, Schleicher County, District 7. Carly Nepkin, Gillespie County, District 10. Jackson Neely, Oldham County, District 1. Charisma Owen, Wichita County, District 3. J.C. Petty, Oldham County, District 1. Jillian Pfeiffer, Tom Green County, District 7. Cutter Pullman, Death Smith County, District 1. Madison Schulze, Guadalupe County, District 10. Ashley Scribner, Wilson County, District 10. Riley Stokes, Lynn County, District 2. Mackenzie Strigler, McCullough County, District 7. Kelly Tondry, Bear County, District 10. Michael Trimble, Bear County, District 10. Elise Valdez, Bear County, District 10. Michaela Weiser, Kerr County, District 10.
I'm Wendy Scott, District 2 4-H Specialist. What an honor and pleasure it is to address the class of 2020. To a group of kids born in the aftermath of 9/11, to a class that now graduates in the middle of a pandemic, you've experienced many life-defining moments for our country and our world. But what we want you to realize is these do not have to be your defining moments. You have total control over what those look like. You've probably been told that as you leave high school, you're given a clean slate. It's never truly a clean slate. What I like to say is you get to continue writing your book of life. Take your book, pick it up, put those final touches on what your high school chapter are and your 4-H chapter, and simply turn the page. What you're going to find is a blank slate simply waiting for you to pick up your pen and write your life-defining moments. Congratulations and good luck to the class of 2020.
The misconception with McCoy's with some people is that we're just a mom and pop. There was a gentleman that came in and he had plans for some condos that are going up. So in the middle of us talking about this pretty big project that he had, he says to me, geez, I didn't realize that you guys were as big as what you are.
In today's world out there, there's a lot of unknowns. Being a builder, repair, remodeler, comes a lot of stress. You're dealing with the subs, the vendors, the financial aspect.
Technology in building is always changing. So my job is to understand what a customer's looking for and be able to provide them different options.
If we're not there on time, if we don't have the correct materials to your job sites, if you have one big job go bad on you, that could really put your company in jeopardy.
We're big enough to take care of your project, but we're small enough to care. Our delivery service is exemplary.
We try to connect our builders and subs together.
We take pride in keeping a good inventory and great selection.
We either have it or we can get it.
We hand pull all of our loads in the yard, and we've trained our folks to only give you the best quality that we could get.
We have a very experienced crew that knows how to get the job done.
If I tell a customer that our truck will be there at mid-morning, they know that that truck will be pulling in mid-morning.
You know, if we notice something that's not right, we try to fix that immediately.
We're there to help you with your project from start to finish.
We're always looking for the opportunity to support our customer.
25% of McCoy's employees have been with us for over 10 years.
We have over 85 stores. We've been in the business over 80 years.
We've got over 350 delivery trucks hitting the road any day of the week.
You walk in and it seems like you're still with your own family.
We care about your business. We care about folks. It's not always about making money.
We take pride in knowing that you chose us.
My community is really supportive. If we need something, your neighbor's right there to help you out. And that's why I love San Antonio so much and Texas in general. I have a family of 8, so there's 6 kids and my parents. We're pretty close. We do a lot of 4-H things together. That's our family thing. Without my siblings, I definitely don't think I would be the person I am today. They definitely bring the best out of me. I was diagnosed with alopecia areata at 9.5 years old. Alopecia areata is an autoimmune disease where your body attacks your hair follicles and makes them fall out. I didn't know how to react to it, but the 4-H members and family around me, they were my number one supporters through it. Someone I loved struggled with their mental health, so I wanted to take action to educate other people on mental health, so that's when I started the Navigating Your Thoughts project to fight mental health stigma and, most importantly, educate others on mental health. Being diagnosed with alopecia areata, I've gone through depression and anxiety and not really feeling like wanted and just not feeling myself. So I know what it feels like. Navigate Your Thoughts program is a 4-week program where we learn mental health, what is mental illness, We identify what is anxiety, depression, and also we talk about stigma. When I first talk to a group, I always ask, what is health to you? And they're always like, oh, exercising 60 minutes a day, eating all the groups in the My Plate. And when I bring up, well, health is also mental health too, the light bulb goes off. The Navigating Your Thoughts Project is growing tremendously. I'm working with AgriLife Extension to incorporate into military 4-H clubs and school clubs. One major thing I've learned through this entire project and in my life is you just never know what a person's going through. So I think just being kind to them and watch what you say and how you word things, I definitely learned that.
I'm so glad to come to you virtually to welcome you to your time that would have been in Bryan College Station. And let me tell you, we are missing every single one of you right now. We were wishing you were here. We want to just celebrate with you. We want to share our community with you, but unfortunately, we're not able to do that. So instead, I'm going to just tell you right now that we're so excited that we can at least get to you this way and that we can thank you for even hopefully missing Bryan College Station and looking forward to coming back in 2021 and having you here to be with us. And by then, we'll probably have several new things that we'll be able to share with you. And we're just excited that we have this opportunity now to say thank you for all the years you have been here and that we look forward to you coming back in 2021. We know that this year has been an interesting year for all of us. And one of the things that we're most proud of is that we get the opportunity to say congratulations to all of our seniors. We know that you're going to go on to do some great things, and we wish that we could have sent you off from Bryan College Station with all of the excitement around that, but we can't. And so we're excited that we can at least tell you congratulations. You're going to do some great, great things. And for those of you that we're going to get to see next year, we're going to welcome you back with open arms and be so excited to have you here.
Hello, on behalf of the City of Bryan, I want to welcome you guys and to your virtual meeting. I'm sorry you're not able to be here physically with us this June for Roundup, but we sure hope to see you next year. As a former member of 4-H myself, I can tell you that what you're doing is very, very important. Probably other than my mom and dad, 4-H probably helped prepare me to serve in a leadership position more than anything else. Speaking skills, developing skills is one of the probably the largest youth development organization, over 100 years old. You're part of a very special organization. I want to tell you congratulations, especially to the seniors. I know this has been a strange year for your senior year. My son's a senior, and we've been doing this together. But, you know, it'll be a year that you'll never forget. And you guys will win first place in the history of senior skip day, and you didn't even get in trouble for it. So anyway, just want to welcome you. Look forward to seeing you here next year at Roundup. God bless you, and I'll hand it off to Mayor Mooney of College Station. But on behalf of everyone in the City of Bryan, as the Mayor of Bryan, I want to tell you that we sure hope you have a great rest of your year and look forward to seeing you here next year. Mayor?
Thank you, Andrew. Well, howdy. On behalf of the City of College Station, the City Council, and everyone who does business or lives in College Station, I just want to welcome you to this particular virtual meeting. I know this year has been unlike anything that any of us could have imagined. I'm sitting here at home, as many of you are, I'm sure, and just really saddened in some ways that we could not have you all here in College Station. You represent 4,000 plus of the best and finest that the state of Texas has in its public and private schools. And so every year we look forward to you coming to College Station and sharing your thoughts, showing how intelligent, how bright, how energetic you all are. And so not having you here really is a disappointment for us all. But we are looking forward to next June or next May when you'll be back here to be able to join us and to celebrate all the accomplishments that everyone has done. 4-H is an unbelievable organization, 100 years plus in operating and sharing things with students. And the fact is, the things you're doing now will really serve as the foundation, being as resilient as you've been this past semester, right, and on into this summer, really demonstrates a level of skill that you maybe never even thought you would have. But I can guarantee you, what has happened during this pandemic and the technology that everyone has had to learn and use, even old dogs like myself, right, shows that, hey, we can adapt and we can achieve goals even when the chips seem to be down. So thank you for participating. Thank you for staying with all the things that you needed to do to get to this point. It will carry you forward, and someday you'll be sitting around and your grandchildren will say, what was it like in 2020? Or as they said in the movie Back to the Future, Marty, whatever you do, don't go to 2020. Gig 'em.
Hey, 4-H scholars. Dottie Gable here with Youth Livestock and Ag at the State 4-H headquarters. Just want to say congratulations on being a scholar. I know that this is a lot of time, effort, energy, and resources that went into making this moment happen. And it's a pretty big deal. I know from personal experience how impactful a 4-H scholarship is as you go into your college experience. So, from all of us, we're proud for you, we're here for you, and we challenge you to take all that you've learned throughout your time in 4-H and carry it forward with your peers and as you go through college and beyond. For you guys, we know that the very best is still yet to come. Congratulations.
Receiving the $3,000 Ag Workers Mutual Auto Insurance and TC AAA Scholarship is Deja Paredes, Andrews County, District 6. Receiving the Annette Louise Couch Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $10,000 is Shannon Anderson, Guadalupe County, District 10. Receiving the Bill Peel Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $5,000 is Joshua Kingston, Parker County, District 3. Receiving the $3,000 Bob Benson Memorial Scholarship is Katie Harris, Brown County, District 7. Receiving the Davidson Foundation Scholarships in the amount of $5,000 are Emily Baker, Travis County, District 10. Colton Bennett, Wilson County, District 10. Jacob Crishone, Brazos County, District 9. Heidi Grilke, Oldham County, District 1. Rebecca Hilly, Colorado County, District 11. Heath Hollis, Milam County, District 8. Jacob Jinsky, Gillespie County, District 10. J.P. John, Dimmitt County, District 12. Peyton Royal, Glasscock County, District 6. Jacqueline Smith, Cook County, District 4. Micah Stewart, Uvalde County, District 10. Allie Treadwell, Tom Green County, District 7. Adeline White, Palmer County, District 2. Austin Wolf, Crosby County, District 2. Receiving the Dixon Allen Foundation Scholarships in the amount of $5,000 are Mia Oshenbeck, Washington County, District 11. Garrett Bernstein, Milam County, District 8. Wesley Bowl, Goliad County, District 11. Cecilia Shaner, Goliad County, District 11. Karen Waters, Cameron County, District 12. Receiving the $3,000 Doyle Warren Scholarship is Alden Schrader, Washington County, District 11. Receiving the Farm Credit Associations of Texas Scholarships in the amount of $3,000 are Braley Schomburg, Washington County, District 11. Megan Schultz, Fayette County, District 11. Carly Thompson, Hempfield County, District 1. Receiving the Floyd Lynch Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $3,000 is Madison Cook, Lubbock County, District 2. Receiving the Fort Worth Stock Show and Rodeo Scholarships in the amount of $4,000 are Hannah Caswell, Scurry County, District 2. LaKayla Phillips, Hunt County, District 4. Elizabeth Shepler, Anderson County, District 5. Shelby Sprinkle, Grayson County, District 4. Receiving the Fort Worth Stock Show Syndicate Scholarships in the amount of $10,000 are Madeline Adams, Brown County, District 7. Peter Cole, Henderson County, District 5. Alyssa Elmore, Lubbock County, District 2. Jet Hennefe, Medina County, District 10. Caleb Herfer, Guadalupe County, District 10. Molly Johnson, Castro County, District 2. Cody Miller, Tom Green County, District 7. Sierra Sebesta, Burleson County, District 9. Reed Seidenberger, Glasscock County, District 6. Alexander Smith, Hempfield County, District 1. Kyle Strobel, Moore County, District 1. Kennedy Wood, Hockley County, District 2. Receiving the Garland and Mildred Powers Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $4,000 is Blake Graves, Coleman County, District 7. Receiving the Governor Bill and Vera Faye Daniels Scholarship in the amount of $3,000 is Bryson Goldman, Nueces County, District 11. Receiving the Heart of Texas Fair and Rodeo Scholarships in the amount of $3,000 are Andrew Exley, Williamson County, District 8. Alexander Hausmuller, Bear County, District 10. Receiving the $3,000 Hiram McGee Memorial Scholarship is Herbert Nolke, Pecos County, District 6. receiving the Johnny Schultz Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $3,000 is Sadie Thibodeau, Gonzales County, District 10. Receiving the KH Family Foundation Scholarships in the amount of $3,000 are Hunter Hines, Ellis County, District 8. Nolan Steffek, Lavaca County, District 11. Receiving the $5,000 Lakita Inns and Suites by Wyndham Scholarship is Elizabeth Eckelberg, Austin County, District 11. Receiving the Marcus and Adriana Hill Scholarship in the amount of $3,000 is Juna Glasscock, Llano County, District 7. The individuals receiving the McLean Estate Scholarships in the amount of $5,000 are Natalie Anderson, Starr County, District 12. Bethany Crenwilge, Gillespie County, District 10. Preston Dahlmeyer, Wilson County, District 10. Garrett Drawback, Lavaca County, District 11. Jillian Hackett, Montgomery County, District 9. Taj Cumberley, Medina County, District 10. Emily Marquez, Cameron County, District 12. Joseph Nino, Hayes County, District 10. Javier Ramirez, Travis County, District 10. Colby C., Burleson County, District 9. Shelby Slover, Goliad County, District 11. John Winsky, Lavaca County, District 11. Receiving the Producers Cooperative Association Scholarships in the amount of $4,000 are Madeline Caperton, Madison County, District 9. Rachel Gallagher, Jim Wells County, District 12. Bailey Lamb, Walker County, District 9. receiving the Stanley and Geneva Schaefer Scholarship in the amount of $5,000 is Conley Eben, Hayes County, District 10. Receiving the Steve Jones Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $3,000 is Brooke Bigford, Galveston County, District 9. Receiving the Stiles Forum Foundation Scholarships in the amount of $4,500 are Cassidy Brown, Brazos County, District 9. Adeline Utley, Hockley County, District 2. Receiving the Texas Associations of Extension 4-H Agents Scholarship in the amount of $3,000 is Kennedy Marshall, Angelina County, District 5. Receiving the Texas Brush Country Safari Club International Scholarships in the amount of $3,000 are Lucas Bradshaw, Randall County, District 1. Nicholas Withager, Parker County, District 3. Receiving the Texas Farm Bureau Scholarships in the amount of $5,000 are Christy Boff, Karnes County, District 11. Gracie Phillips, Llano County, District 7. Receiving the Texas Grain and Feed Association Scholarship in the amount of $3,090 is Naomi Boyson, Galveston County, District 9. Receiving the Will Looney Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $3,000 is Sarah McFarlane, Waller County, District 9. Receiving the William B. Haley Memorial Scholarships in the amount of $5,000 are Bryant Bordofsky, Calhoun County, District 11. Trinity Height, Swisher County, District 2. The Texas 4-H Foundation offers collegiate scholarships to former 4-H members who have graduated from high school for at least 1 year and have completed a minimum of 30 hours of college credit. The following individuals will receive the Foundation's 2020 Collegiate Scholarships. Tate Jones, Tom Green County, District 7, receiving $5,000 from the Bill Peel Memorial Scholarship. Hannah Hastings, Gillespie County, District 10, receiving $3,000 from the Farm Credit Associations of Texas Scholarship. Colton Walton, Montgomery County, District 9, receiving $4,000 from the Producers Cooperative Association Scholarship. Adelaide Sexton, Parker County, District 3, receiving $3,000 from the Texas Association of 4-H Extension Agents Scholarship. Elisa Otto, Fayette County, District 11, receiving $3,090 from the Texas Grain and Feed Association Scholarship. And Alec McManus, Cameron County, District 12, receiving $3,000 from the Texas Thoroughbred Educational Fund Scholarship.
Congratulations on receiving a Texas 4-H Opportunity Scholarship. We're so proud of you. We know you will use it to go do awesome things that will make us even more proud. So congratulations and good luck.
I'm Stephen Ebling. I'm a fifth generation farmer. My family has farmed and run cattle on the same piece of ground for over 120 years. We raise Black Angus cattle, and then we grow cotton, wheat, cucumbers, and seed millet. You just get up and go to work, and you just work, and you never finish. The nice thing about Capital Farm Credit is it's rooted in agriculture. When I call and I say, hey, I need this done, it's a matter of minutes, not a matter of days or weeks. Capital Farm Credit understands that we're doing our part, and together, we're better for it, and we will get there.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the first ever virtual Texas 4-H Roundup. My name is Weston Bauer, and I'll be giving you today's special report. So, let's get to it. The past few months have been pretty crazy, but amidst the confusion, the directors of Texas 4-H have been working hard to provide educational and engaging opportunities for 4-H'ers stuck at home. This year, Texas 4-H is offering a virtual adaptation of a new event that was introduced at Roundup last year, LEAD Academy. Our reporter Caroline Sexton has the details.
I'm here with Ms. Janet Barrett, a 4-H program specialist and event coordinator for Texas 4-H Roundup. So why was LEAD Academy started?
LEAD Academy was started in 2019, and it was a way to take our workshop series that we had been offering through Texas 4-H Roundup and to provide them a more focused approach.
What are some of the benefits that you've seen from LEAD Academy?
One of the main reasons we decided to take LEAD Academy to a virtual experience this year, knowing that the face-to-face event was going to be canceled, was because of the impact that we felt we made on young people last year who participated. Those members provided us with information that said, you know, because of our workshop and the opportunity they had to learn more about Playa, Texas, it helped them to be able to fill out that application come July 1.
Do you foresee any changes being made next year based on what's happened with everything going online?
Obviously, we hope that this is not the new norm for us, and we are able to find a better way to coexist with COVID-19, and that we can, you know, get back to more of our face-to-face engagement opportunities with our young people as well as our volunteers, etc. However, we are taking this time to look at the opportunity we have to reach a new audience potentially through our virtual platform. Obviously with LEAD Academy, that's one thing we felt, you know, there may be people that are now able to participate in this event that traditionally would not have been coming to College Station in June. So we're just taking the opportunity to explore those ideas and be able to, make the best better for what we're doing and how we're doing it and continuing to provide the opportunities for our young people, even though they may not be our traditional way at this time.
Well, thank you so much, Mrs. Barrett, for taking the time to answer these questions, and back to you.
Thanks, Caroline. Though COVID-19 has kept us at home, it hasn't kept 4-H'ers from making a difference. Youth across the state have sprung into action and continued to make the best better. Let's see what Texas 4-H has been up to during the coronavirus.
Hi, my name is Julia Guzman. I'm from Castroville 4-H.
And my name is John Guzman, and I'm from Castroville 4-H.
So some things that we're doing during quarantine to make a difference in our communities is Castrol 4-H and Dean Valley Athletics are collaborating to collect food for St. Vincent de Paul. We've also made over 100 cards for first responders and health professionals in our area and in San Antonio to thank them for their service.
Castrol 4-H and Medina Valley Youth Baseball Association are working together to collect bats and helmets for the teams all around the world that are less fortunate, such as the Dominican Republic.
Wow, those videos were on point, or should I say, online. That was awful. Thanks for tuning in to this afternoon's newscast brought to you by the STEAM Ambassadors. We hope you will join us next year at the 2021 Texas 4-H Roundup. Until then, have a great rest of the evening and enjoy the rest of Lead Academy.
Hey, Texas 4-H'ers, Cody Davenport here, Executive Director and CEO of the San Antonio Stock Show and Rodeo. I'm happy to be here talking to you guys on behalf of our 6,000 volunteers and dedicated staff that we have working year-round. You know, these are definitely trying times, times with some adversity in them, but you guys come from a long generation of people that have stood tall at times of adversity. Our industry of agriculture has produced some very resilient individuals, and we know that each and every one of you is built and ready to follow suit in those footsteps. We are positive about our future. When we look at each and every one of you, we know that next generation is going to keep us strong and that you will carry us through times like this. So on behalf of San Antonio, congratulations to each and every one of you. We're happy to be on this journey with you. I'm also happy to stand here in front of you today and say that by partnering with Texas 4-H, we're able to give out $272,000 to 25 recipients out there, plus all of our school tours winners. We appreciate what you guys do. We appreciate the leadership that you're providing in our great state of Texas, and we look forward to the accomplishments that you have coming in the future. God bless each and every one of you, and let's rodeo San Antonio.
Receiving the San Antonio Livestock Show and Rodeo Exposition Scholarships in the amount of $20,000 are Annabeth Allison, Hale County, District 2. Callie Childress, Dallam County, District 1. Kate Crenwelge, Gillespie County, District 10. Renata Gaday, Travis County, District 10. Kayla Hadash, Montgomery County, District 9. Brantley Hoover, Midland County, District 6. Jacob Mayfield, Denton County, District 4. Hannah Moore, Denton County, District 4.
Justin Swise, Goliad County, District 11. Sarah Thuray, Carnes County, District 11. Ryan Williamson, Wharton County, District 11. Macy Wisdom, Parker County, District 3. Sarah Wofford, Cherokee County, District 5.
The following students have been awarded the San Antonio Livestock Show and Rodeo Exposition School Tour Scholarships in the amount of $1,000. Logan Arnett, Medina County, District 10. Lane Berry, Jefferson County, District 9. Jared Crowley, Bexar County, District 10. Isabella Faulkner, Bexar County, District 10. Olivia Garza, Medina County, District 10. Celia Lopez, Medina County, District 10. Addison McElvey, Goliad County, District 11. Matthew Murphy, Boss County, District 8. Logan Piker, Angelina County, District 5. Casey Russell, B County, District 11. Riley Thomas, Guadalupe County, District 10. Brooke Yanta, Goliad County, District 11.
Howdy, Texas 4-H Scholarship recipients, and a special shout out to the District 11 4-H Scholarship recipients. We are extremely proud of each and every one of you and your accomplishments throughout your 4-H career. It has been an honor and a privilege to be part of the wonderful memories made, whether it be at 4-H camps, livestock shows, or through 4-H contests and events.
We know that your 2020 senior year was cut very short. There's been a lot of hardships, and a lot of things have been canceled. But guys, we are Texas 4-H strong, and we need to reflect and look back over all those experiences and activities that we've done throughout the years.
From the late nights to the practices and contests, stock shows and service projects, and everything in between, we hope that you enjoyed your time as a 4-H member and value all of the lessons learned and memories made.
Texas 4-H and D11, you've made a lasting impact on us as your 4-H leaders and your peers. We are incredibly proud of the people you've become. You are a resilient group of individuals. I want to leave you with this quote by Brooke Davis. Sometimes life will kick you around, but sooner or later, you realize you're not just a survivor. You're a warrior, and you're stronger than anything life throws your way.
Congratulations!
Hey, Texas 4-H is going to be so happy to meet you, Clovey. You know, I really wish that we could have introduced you to all of the organization at Roundup, but I'm super happy that my council got to adopt you into this 4-H family. Hey, while you're down there, can you go take a look at Reed Arena and keep an eye out there while we're not over there? Thanks, Clovey. Hey, I can't wait to see you in person, and I know the rest of the organization is going to be thrilled to have you with us. See ya.
Hey, Clovey, it's so good to see you. I hope you've been staying safe during this quarantine. I know this week is a little bit different than we imagined, but I hope you can keep your head up. Hey, but since you live at Texas A&M, would you mind doing me a huge favor, going over to the Pierce Pavilion to check out the pavilion for us? I really wish that we would be in there judging some livestock this year, but I hope that we can see you there next year. Thank you!
Clovy, you got lucky. I was totally going to win the dance-off this year around them. But I have to admit, you have some pretty sick moves, and I cannot wait to see them next year. But in the meantime, show off those skills around campus, because, you know, we all miss getting to walk past Kyle Field. See you next year, man. Peace out. Clovy, dude, why is Whataburger so good? But I'm sure it's all the same being there without the 4-H Council. At least you're keeping up the tradition. Hey, can we promise Texas 4-H that they'll be seeing you online and in events next year? Okay, sounds good. Bye.
Clovy, my friends and I sure have some fun memories from our time in College Station. Especially from those pool parties at the Wyndham Hotel. Will you go check one out for us? What a fun official mascot you are, Clovy. See you next year.
For a century, Farm Credit has been supporting rural communities and agriculture with reliable, consistent credit and financial services. But do you know why Farm Credit was created? Rural enterprises and agriculture are essential, yet volatile. Farm Credit was created to help rural communities from coast to coast weather financial ups and downs. Our access to financial resources and cooperative structure have allowed us to remain strong through bad and good times.
Thanks.
Farm Credit supports the diverse financial needs of farmers, ranchers, and rural businesses. We also help rural communities thrive by financing vital infrastructure and communication services. That steady flow of credit means more jobs, more economic growth, and more investment in rural America. Today's beginning farmers are the backbone of tomorrow's rural communities. That's why Farm Credit actively supports youth leadership programs like 4-H and the FFA and makes an average of 60,000 loans to beginning farmers each year. As a network of cooperatives, each locally owned by our borrowers, Farm Credit profits are returned directly to our customers, which helps strengthen the rural economy. Our mission has always been to support rural communities and agriculture, making America strong. Today and tomorrow. Visit findfarmcredit.com to learn more.
I am Shannon Anderson from Guadalupe County, District 10. With me tonight will be
Kara Pinkerton, Smith County, District 5.
Zach Holscher, McLennan County, District 8.
Tonight, we are honoring our 2020 Texas 4-H Salute to Excellence Award recipients. These honorees are true examples of leaders that do not necessarily set out to be a leader, they set out to make a difference. Today's honorees have changed the lives of many young people in the Texas 4-H program. They have given countless hours, financial resources, their own personal and family time, and their hearts. For that, we salute you for your commitment, dedication, and leadership.
Our first award is the Meritorious Service Award. The Meritorious Service Award is awarded annually to two outstanding extension professionals based on their role in making 4-H volunteers more effective and the impact they have on 4-H members. The first recipient of this award is Wendy Scott, 4-H Program Specialist from District 2. And the second is Mark Arnold, County Extension Agent from Ellis County, District 8. Our next award is the Commendable Service Award. The Commendable Service Award is awarded annually to outstanding support staff professionals for their role in making the 4-H program more effective. Our winners for this award are Heather Edgar, Texas 4-H Center, Sue Ferguson from the Texas 4-H Office, and Tammy Goodwin from Hardin County, District 9. And the next award for tonight is our Citation for Outstanding Service to 4-H. This is an award recognizing an individual or business that has made an outstanding contribution to Texas 4-H programs on a regional or state level basis. Our winners for this award are Lawson Equipment from Mills County District 7, and Pat Carter from XTO Energy, Lamar County, District 4. The Leader's Legacy Award recognizes a 4-H leader who has been an integral part of the 4-H Youth Development Program for 20 years or more. The person who is nominated for this award may or may not be the person who is always in the spotlight, but is the one who makes an impact and a difference on the 4-H members with whom he or she works. Our winners for this award tonight are Renee Chapman, Nueces County, District 11, and Larry and Skip Simmons, Swisher County, District 2. Our Texas 4-H Alumni Award recognizes adults who have made significant achievements in their communities and who have shown evidence of 4-H's influence in their adult lives. They provide continued service to the 4-H program today. Our winners for this award are Tommy Calvert, Denton County, District 4, and J.C. Hammer, Carson County, District 1.
Texas 4-H Salute to Excellent Award recognizes outstanding 4-H volunteers for their service to 4-H programs and the impact that they have had on the lives of young people. Tara Ogletree, Carson County, District 1. Clifford Oldham, Wheeler County, District 1. Marla Cook, Lyon County, District 2. Nancy Coode, Nome County, District 3. Larry Brown, Cass County, District 4. Lorena Phillips, Hunt County, District 4. Amy Jones, Anderson County, District 5. Rick and Jennifer Foreman, Upshur County, District 5. Benjamin Hotta, Andrews County, District 6. Casey and Judy Upham, Crockett County, District 6. Terry Hollis, Callahan County, District 7. Kay Stewart, San Saba County, District 7. Barbara Wood, Bell County, District 8. Cara Ellison, Johnson County, District 8. Justin Lyon, Lee County, District 9. Patrick McAshlin, Galveston County, District 9. Jennifer Dietrich, Bear County, District 10. Tina Warwick, Travis County, District 10. Jackie Parsons, Victoria County, District 11. Shalane Pinkerton, Nueces County, District 11. Jody Bullard, Dimmitt County, District 12.
Congratulations to our 2020 award recipients. We know that it is with you that we can help continue to make the best better in the lives of 4-H members across the state of Texas.
Howdy, Texas 4-H members. This is Chris Bowman, President and CEO here at the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo. We know 2020 has been difficult on so many of us, and we know that we're coming to you virtually this year, and that's a change and probably something you didn't expect like so many of us. We hope that you continue to be healthy and safe as we work through COVID-19, and for us, that's our number one priority. Hey, but you know what? Today's a great day. And we are so excited to announce our 2020 Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo Scholarship winners. What a great day, and you have earned this, and we are so looking forward to you using these resources to better yourself as you start your college career. We can't wait to see you at the 2021 show, and we are fully prepared to welcome you back with open arms as we get ready for that show. And saying that, in closing, let me welcome our new scholarship winners to the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo family.
The following individuals will be receiving the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo Scholarship in the amount of $20,000. Randolph Harris, Fannin County, District 4. Darren Ashby, Angelina County, District 5. Jasmine Baker, Williamson County, District 8. Colton Baldridge, Lubbock County, District 2. Shane Basham, Baylor County, District 3. Bailey Becker, Collin County, District 4. Seth Berry, Hale County, District 2. Isabel Betancourt, Bexar County, District 10. Holt Chambers, Clay County, District 3. Mary Coggins, Valverde County, District 6. Caden Cornelius, Crosby County, District 2. Kyle Coward, Coryell County, District 8. Cassidy Cradock, Grayson County, District 4. Haley Crumley, McLennan County, District 8. Brianne Coo, Knox County, District 3. Luke Daniels, Dallam County, District 1. Amy Dittmar, Gillespie County, District 10. Allison Duncan, San Patricio County, District 11. Blake Dunkel, Archer County, District 3. Sean Earthman, Knox County, District 3. Addison Elliott, Childress County, District 3. Riley Elliott, Wahlberger County, District 3. Megan Freirich, San Patricio County, District 11. Gunner Garnett, Goliad County, District 11. Bailey Glaze, Grayson County, District 4. Blake Graves, Coleman County, District 7. Garrett Guerrero, Tom Green County, District 7. Trace Harris, Wilson County, District 10. Kendall Hastings, Gillespie County, District 10. Abby Herms, Lavaca County, District 11. Mark Holtman, Tom Green County, District 7. Julia Hornsby, Fort Bend County, District 9. Katie Howe, Caldwell County, District 10. Miles Huffines, Randall County, District 1. Gentry Jackson, Wood County, District 5. Seth Kendrick, Montgomery County, District 9. Mary Jo Cutsmod, Brazos County, District 9. Megan Kopecky, Wilson County, District 10. Will Lau, Victoria County, District 11. Karen Lawrence, Eastland County, District 8. Claire Lee, Hidalgo County, District 12. Bailey Lyon, Lee County, District 9. Macy McCollum, Wise County, District 3. Natalie McDaniel, Dahlem County, District 1. Rebecca McDaniel, Hayes County, District 10. Kate McNeil, Atascosa County, District 12. Brooke Meismer, Kerr County, District 10. Casey Metcalf, Collin County, District 4. Abigail Miller, Milam County, District 8. Cade Miller, Carson County, District 1. Mackenzie Miller, Carson County, District 1. Abby Murphy, Wilson County, District 10. Taylor O'Brien, San Patricio County, District 11. Dylan Outlaw, Brazos County, District 9. Ty Pargman, Wilson County, District 10. Autumn Perryman, Motley County, District 3. Emma Ranley, Bell County, District 8. Armand Rathgib, Collin County, District 4. Victoria Richards, Young County, District 3. Lindsay Sawn, Wahlberger County, District 3. Caroline Sexton, Parker County, District 3. Catherine Shipman, Schleicher County, District 7. Grayson Sims, Angelina County, District 5. Wyatt Sisko, Sterling County, District 7. Hannah Faith Smith, Uvalde County, District 10. Auburn Sorrels, Dahlem County, District 1. Reuben Stetcher, Kaufman County, District 4. Gabriel Sumrall, Matagorda County, District 11. Lindsay Thormalin, Guadalupe County, District 10. Presley Wireball, Comal County, District 10.
Congratulations to all of our 2020 Texas 4-H Opportunity Scholarship recipients. The Texas 4-H Foundation wishes you all the best in your future endeavors.
...2020 Texas 4-H Opportunity Scholarship winners. You know, when I think of the year that you all have had, I'm in awe of your resilience, your ability to maintain positive thinking, and honestly, a determination to push through all of this. I know that it hasn't been easy for any of you. However, the reality is that what you're about to pursue in college and in life is not easy. So the reality is that every single one of you has proven that you have what it takes to push through difficult times and be successful. And I think that your scholarship is indicative of the belief that our program has in you to do just that. So again, congratulations on this tremendous accomplishment, and go out and do great things in the world.
Hi, I'm Steve Martin with South Texas TAC, and I'm excited to be able to introduce my family, my wife Nancy, and my daughter Elle. South Texas TAC is really excited to announce a new partnership with the Texas State 4-H and South Texas TAC. This is a project we've worked on for nearly a year, and we're able to roll it out this last April with tremendous response. South Texas TAC has always been, since 2003, our inception, always been interested in kids and agriculture, and kids, period. And this was just a tremendous opportunity to put all of our efforts together, concentrated in one group, and get behind them, and not just as a regional level, but to cover really the whole state. And we're just really excited about the opportunity. Nancy's going to tell you a little bit about the Texas State 4-H member program that South Texas TAC is offering.
The member benefits for all Texas 4-H members and new members that South Texas TAC is offering is 5% off their total purchase on qualifying items. In addition to the 5% off, South Texas TAC is going to be giving the Texas 4-H 5% off each purchase back to the foundation to support programs and scholarships throughout the state. We have set the member benefits up to be used online and in our store by Texas 4-H members and their families. Our daughter Elle would like to step you through the sign-up process.
Hi everyone, I'm Elle Martin, a Texas 4-H member. I participate in the Bluebonnet 4-H in Washington County. I'd like to show you how easy it is to sign up for the South Texas TAC Texas 4-H member benefits. From the weekly email you receive from being a Texas 4-H member, at the bottom of the email is a link to South Texas TAC. Once you get to this page, you will have two options. Option 1, already a South Texas TAC member, or Option 2, new South Texas TAC member. If you are already a customer, you'll need to log in right here. If not, click the new South Texas TAC customer and fill out the form to create your account. Now you're logged in and can receive your South Texas TAC Texas 4-H member benefits. Once you join, you're signed up. The hard part is over. Shop online or in the Brenham store to receive and give your 5%. Thank you for helping us support Texas 4-H. We appreciate you.
Congratulations to the 2020-2021 Texas 4-H Council at-large delegates. Candidate number 3, Trevor Martinez. Candidate number 5, Luke Reed. Candidate number 8, Lexi I. Candidate number 9, Caitlin Hughes. Candidate number 10, Brent LeBlanc. And candidate number 11, Cameron Jones.
As our year together comes to a close, we as Texas 4-H Council hope that we have helped make it a year to remember. For us, this year will go down as one of the greatest in our lives. From learning to be a hero, to getting the opportunity to explore our nation's capital as a family, our experience has been nothing short of life-changing. So, on behalf of Texas 4-H Council, thank you, because we would be nothing without each and every one of you.
Unfortunately, this was not the ending that we had in mind to cap off such a great year. We know that moving forward will be hard after an obstacle like this seems to have set us back so much. But what doesn't kill us only makes us stronger, and luckily, we have our 4-H family to turn to for support. Whether it's your first year in 4-H or your last, the knowledge and skills that you have acquired through your 4-H journey will be the ones that guide you for the rest of your life. So no matter where your road leads or what adventures life takes you on, we wish you the very best of luck.
We all know it's hard to find a good starting point when describing an experience, especially a 4-H experience. For us council members, I guess the most appropriate starting point would be in July, when the 30 of us first met at the Texas 4-H Center in Brownwood. When we met, we had no clue the treasurable moments, unforgettable experiences, and valuable relationships that we would build throughout this next year. We all know this year has had its ups and downs, with successes and failures, and a lot of recent discouragements. But just like this chair I'm sitting in, that belonged to my great-great-grandmother and is still standing strong today, we have proven that no matter the adversity we face, we will succeed. We've proven that as members and as an organization, we stand strong. As a council, we have stood strong. Without each and every one of your support, feedback, and friendliness over this past year, our council wouldn't be what we are. Texas 4-H, thank you for the best years of our life. Without you, we wouldn't be where we are today. And I wouldn't change this past year or trade it for anything in the world. Thank you, Texas 4-H. Love,
Shannon.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you want to go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, my wish,
Eric.
Sean.
Cooper. Parker.
All the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret. And you help somebody every chance you get.
Zach.
Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake. And always give more than you take. But more than anything. Yeah, more than anything.
Molly.
Avery.
Bailey.
Kason.
Lydia.
Lauren.
My wish for you is that this life becomes all
Trenton.
Victoria.
Peyton.
Alex.
Reed. Colby.
Zane.
Mark.
Set.
Keep that hunger. May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid
Gentry.
Love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean.
Ty.
Choice to sit it
Brayden.
Out or dance. I hope you dance.
I hope and Grady McAllister, your 2019-2020 Texas 4-H Council President. Thank you.
Hey friends, my name is Dalton Domino. I am a songwriter and a country music artist from Lubbock, Texas. I just want to take a minute and say how much I support you guys and what the 4-H program stands for. There is nothing in this world that I hold in a more high regard than those who lead kids in the right direction. So what you guys are doing is absolutely incredible. What you're doing for your community and for each other. And to all you 4-H'ers out there, thank you so much for letting me be a part of this. I wish I was there at the 4-H State Roundup. I wish I could be there in person, so maybe next time. Anyway, here's a song I wrote called Jesus in Handbags. I hope you like it.
Mm-hmm.
tattoos and she wears pearls. And hell on wheels, she's daddy's little girl. She's my guiding light on my darkest days. But her own shelter when the world turns away. And my eyes are best friend. She wants a man like her dad and sister. And red and white are the only two she talks to when she's mad. She says, all a woman needs is Jesus and handbags. But I love her most in boots and jeans. No makeup with her hair a mess. Rather than her Sunday's best. My eyes are best friend. She wants a man like her dad, her sister. And red wine are the only two she talks to when she's mad. She says, all a woman needs is Jesus and handbags. All I want is you. This Texas mountain is tangled up in blue. Cause you're all I got to lose. Living proof that hope exists. With a flawless sway that's heaven sent. It's nothing short but elegance and grace. She's all I want from all my days. My eyes are best friend. She wants a man like her dad, her sister. And red and white are the only two talks to when she's mad. She says, all the woman needs is Jesus and handbags. All the woman needs is Jesus and handbags. And let's see here. I'll do one more for you guys if that's okay. Like I mentioned earlier, I'm a songwriter and I write songs for other people. If you listen to country music, there's a guy out there named William Clark Green. And this is a song I got to write with William. The song's called Poor. I'm a sucker, a sinner, three times a loser, a fool who can't buy you a ring. You're a lady, a saint, three times what I ain't, yet somehow a queen like you pick me. You don't care about the bills in the mailbox, or my name and what it means to some folks. Say the secondhand life is all I need to get by. You make it feel pretty good being poor. There's cracks in the ceiling. I love the feeling of watching you stuck in a dream. You let out a smile. For a while, when you're sleeping, you're dreaming of me. You don't care about the bills in the mailbox, or my name and what it means to some folks. You say the secondhand life is all I need to get by. You make you feel pretty good being poor. Na 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 na
caring about the bills in the mailbox. I'm minding on what it means to some folks. They say the second-hand life is all you need to get by. You make it feel pretty good being poor. I know we ain't got much, but we're so rich in love, and it feels pretty good being poor. Once again, my name is Dalton Domino, and thank you so much for letting me be a part of your special day. I appreciate it, and hopefully I see all you guys soon.
I've had fun celebrating with you as we've enjoyed the accomplishments of so many different things in Texas 4-H. I hope you've enjoyed the evening with your family while sitting in your living room. Congratulations again, and I look forward to seeing you next year.